Paranormal events are often easily explained away or disproven by simple scientific procedure. However, this was not the case for the notorious Belmez Faces. One of the most influential cases of paranormal activity documented in the 21st century. In the town of Belmez, Spain, lived a woman by the name of Maria Gomez Pereira, who lived in a small house with her husband Juan and son Miguel. It was during August of 1971 that Maria first noticed a strange looking stain in the center of her kitchen floor. To begin with, Maria thought nothing of the stain, but gradually it formed into something highly disturbing. This was the result after several days had passed. This creepy face terrified Maria, who was unable to scrub it away even when using cleaning chemicals. To calm Maria down and remove the face from the kitchen floor, Juan and Miguel dug up the concrete with a pickaxe and laid fresh cement. Several days after the new floor had been set and things seemed to return to normal, this was short-lived. One day Maria entered the kitchen to find a new face had appeared in the exact same location as the old one. The new face looked more contorted than the last, less defined, but still definitely a face. The family began to conclude perhaps this was a ghost or spirit trying to communicate with them. At this point, word had spread throughout the town of Belmez, and hundreds of people were queuing up to try and get a look at this creepy paranormal occurrence. While Maria wanted to destroy the second face, the mayor of Belmez instead decided to have the concrete dug up for testing to ensure the whole thing wasn't just an elaborate hoax. Scientists found no evidence of chemical tampering, nor was this the result of paintwork, meaning that there was no scientific way to disprove the appearance of these faces. In fact, it proved this was a genuine paranormal event. The creepiest part is yet to come. Upon digging up the kitchen floor, it was discovered that Maria's house had been built on an old graveyard, and that directly below the area of the floor where the faces appeared, the investigators found the remains of several humans. For many, this was all the evidence needed to prove the phenomena true. The human remains were given proper burial and a new floor laid down for Maria and her family. But this wasn't the end of this surreal tale. In the following weeks, more faces appeared. The image of a woman surrounded by many small faces. And the expressions on these faces would change. Sometimes they would look solemn, sometimes they would smile, and other times they would shriek out with a horrifying contorted gaze. This was baffling to skeptics and scientists at the time, especially as all the tests on the concrete came back with no evidence of human tampering. In fact, during a secondary investigation, the family was forced to evacuate the house for several days, and a plastic sheet had been laid across the faces. This was because it was believed sunlight may have been the cause of the changes to the appearance of these faces. The concrete was cut off from sunlight, and the family had no access to tamper during this time. Yet still, new faces showed up and moved around. The investigators also left a tape recorder recording in the house. It recorded these sounds. This phenomena continued for another 30 years, until Maria's death in February 2004. It had been cited by many paranormal investigators that the faces were likely a result of Maria herself, as she was a known psychic. This ideology was known as photographic appearances, the connection of the human mind to the spirit realm. Following Maria's death, new faces did appear, but were quickly disproven as a hoax perpetrated by Maria's second son, Diego Pereira. These were easily proven as traces of paint were discovered when testing took place. The original faces, however, remain an unproven mystery to this day. And that's it for today's video, guys. I hope you did enjoy it. And if you did, remember to give it a like and subscribe for more horror-related content, including theories, analysis, and Let's Play videos. And I will see you on the next one.